In our previous lectures, you have learnt what is a recurring or a cumulative deposit account. Let's recall. An investor deposits a fixed amount every month for a specified number of months, right? So an investor, let the investor be me or you. So suppose I deposit a fixed amount say rupees 1000 every month. Okay, so I have to deposit rupees 1000 every month till how many months? For a specified number of months. So I and the bank will agree on some stated amount of months, and I have to deposit that fixed amount, say rupees 1000, for that specific number of months, and on expiry of this period, which period? This specific number of months. So let me take the specific number of months, say as 24 months. So I have agreed with the bank that I will deposit rupees 1000 every month for 24 months, that is 2 years. Now as this term will expire, as 24 months will end, which is called the maturity period. So after the end of my maturity period, that will be 24 months, he gets the amount deposited by him together with the interest due to him. So I will get rupees 1000 into 24, that is my total money which I have deposited to the bank, and along with that I will get the interest that has been accumulated on my deposits. So what will I get? I get the money which I have deposited plus the interest that is due on my deposits. Now in the previous lectures we've learned how to calculate the interest on such deposits and also how to calculate the maturity amount, that is amount I receive on maturity. But what if in the sums some informations are missing and you have been given the amount of maturity instead? Didn't understand? Let's take an example, you will understand better. Now Saloni had a cumulative time deposit. Cumulative time deposit is same as recurring. So Saloni has a cumulative time deposit in Citibank. She deposits rupees 500 per month. So what is the principal in this case? 500 for a period of 4 years. So she is depositing money, that is rupees 500 per month for a period of 4 years. You know you have to convert this 4 years into number of months. Now if at the time of maturity she gets rupees 28,410. So in this case what is missing? The rate of interest is missing here. So in this sum you have not been given the information that how much was the rate of interest that was offered to Saloni. Instead you have been given that at the time of maturity she received rupees 28,410. So can you help find Saloni? What was the interest offered to her by the bank? Well, let's do it together. First let us write the information. P, that is money deposited per month, rupees 500. N, that is the number of months for which the money is deposited. 4 months? No. 4 into 12. Because the information is 4 years. So 4 into 12, you get 48 months. R, is it given in the sum? No. So R is a question mark for us. Instead, we have been given the amount of maturity. So you can write the amount of maturity is rupees 28,410. Now we know how to calculate interest on our recurring deposits, where SI is equal to P into N into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100, right? But we know P, we know N, but we do not know R. What will we do? We'll keep R as R over here and then let us write this. So SI will be P, that is 500, into N, that is 48, into 48 plus 1 by 2 into 12 into, we do not know R, so let's keep it as R, by 100. Right? Solve this, what do you get? So simplifying this, you get 490 R. So the interest that Saloni received was 490 R, where R is the rate of interest per annum. You know that amount of maturity can be calculated by adding up total money deposited and the interest. Now, we have been given the amount of maturity in the sum, that was 28,410. We have already calculated the interest, right? That was 490 R. But what about the total money deposited? How will we calculate that? You know that per month she was depositing rupees 500 and she has deposited 500 for 48 months. So multiplying this will give a total money deposited. So the total money deposited by Saloni is 500 into 48. This is rupees 24,000. So now we know that the amount of maturity is 28,410. The total money deposited is 24,000 and the interest is 490 R. So we get an expression like this, 24,000 plus 490 R, and the time of maturity she gets rupees 28,410. So let's equate it. 24,000 plus 490 R is 28,410. So find this missing R. Subtract these two, what do you get? 490 R is equal to 4,410. Now R will be divided by 490. So we get R is equal to 9. So rate of interest offered to Saloni was 9% per annum. So what you can do using those two formulas where SI is equal to P into N into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100 and amount of maturity is equal to total money deposited plus interest, you can find out any missing value among these two formulas.